Hello, in this video, we will see Alpha Gamma Coactivation, also called Alpha Gamma Linkage. It's an interesting topic about muscle spindle. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. First, let's quickly revise what we have seen in the video on muscle spindle and stretch reflex. There we saw that muscle has two types of fibers. One is extrafusal fibers. They are the main force generating fibers of the muscle and they are innervated by alpha motor neurons. The second type of fibers is called intrafusal fibers. They mainly play a sensory role as part of muscle spindle. However, their ends also contain contractile elements, so they can also contract. And they are innervated by gamma motor neurons. The central region receives sensory innervation, and it plays a major role in the stretch reflex. What happens is when a muscle is stretched suddenly, the stretch is sensed by the central region of the intrafusal fibers. Via sensory nerve, this information is sent to the spinal cord. This excites a motor neuron to the same muscle, so there will be reflex contraction of that muscle. Thus, the stretch reflex opposes a sudden change in the muscle length. Okay, that's fine. Sensory and alpha motor neurons were involved in this. But what is the role of gamma innervation in all these? Well, this innervation keeps the muscle spindle sensitive to stretch over a large range of muscle length. To understand it, first let's see what would happen without gamma innervation. Imagine we want to move our muscles voluntarily. For this, brain sends a signal via the upper motor neuron to the alpha motor neuron of the relevant muscle. It stimulates the extrafusal fibers and muscle contracts. Now the spindle is connected in parallel to the extrafusal fibers. So the contraction of muscle tends to make spindle go slack. In this state, the spindle is not sensitive to further changes in the length. And that is where gamma innervation comes in. They also receive signals from the same upper motor neuron. So normally, when alpha motor neurons are activated, the gamma motor neurons are also activated along with them. The gamma neuron causes contraction of the intrafusal fiber. This contraction helps maintain tension in the muscle spindle even when the whole muscle is contracted. And this in turn preserves the sensitivity of the muscle spindle. Thus, the simultaneous activation of alpha and gamma neurons increases the range of lengths over which spindle can work. This is called alpha-gamma coactivation or alpha-gamma linkage. So that was the importance of motor innervation of muscle spindle. Now let's have a quick summary. Alpha motor neuron stimulates extrafusal fibers and causes muscle contraction. This tends to make sensory endings on muscle spindle go slack and thus insensitive. But simultaneous activation of gamma motor neurons causes contraction of intrafusal fibers of the muscle spindle. This helps maintain tension and thus preserves the sensitivity of muscle spindle over a wide range of muscle lengths. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.